a year later, he could show that indeed this antigen 2 was responsible for the graft rejection. He could show it by genetic experiments where he crossed the strains and followed which segregating individuals would reject the tumor and which not. And at the same time, he typed them for antigen 2, and he found the perfect correlation. In addition, he realized that the mice that rejected the tumor had antibodies in their blood, and the antibodies was against the antigen 2. So it was clear that the same antigen has two faces. One, it induces antibodies, which then detect it on the red blood cells, and it induces immune response by whatever mechanism that was not known how the tumor is rejected, but by whatever mechanism destroys the tumor. So the antigen must be present also on the tumor cells. The tumor cells were derived probably from the epithelial cells, so it was on the epithelium. And later it could be shown that it was practically everywhere, on every cell. In the meantime, then came war, and he couldn't do much. He continued, but very little, and couldn't do much during the war. But renewed his effort after the war. But in the meantime, in Bar Harbor, George Snell, who was originally a geneticist by training, started a series of experiments trying to find out what were these histocompatibility antigens, these antigens that stimulated the immune system for rejection. And there were indications already at that time. There were many of them. It was not one, but a large number, at least 15 or even more. The problem was how to distinguish them, how to separate from one from the other, because the only thing you knew is when there is a difference in one, it's rejected. So you didn't know whether it was one, two, or three, or so that then he developed the idea of devising congenic, so-called congenic strains, by genetic means would be identical, with the exception of one of these histocompatibility antigens. He started, and he found out that one of these antigens was very strong, in the sense that it very rapidly caused rejection of the tumors. Then I think it was Gorer who contacted George Snell. I don't think it was the other way around, but it turned out that Gorer went to Bar Harbor. They put things together, and they showed that what Gorer discovered and what Snell discovered was one and the same thing. So they decided to call it H2. Because Snell, in the meantime, introduced the names H1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for the individual histocompatibility antigens. So it became H2. And then Gorer continued with his work, mainly serological. That means he was inducing antibodies and finding out in the different combination of strains and finding out how many different antigens there were and so on. And Snell continued his mainly tumor transplantation work, and only later, when Peter Demant joined his laboratory and Mariana Cherry joined him, he also became involved in H2 serology.